2,000 years after the departure of Jesus Christ. The prophets are back to teach the real Jews, the 12 tribes of Israel, their true nationality. This is their campaign.
Now, we want everybody to take a good look at what's going on around the world. All right, because what just happened recently in New York, you had a bombing that occurred in New York. And then secondly, you had a bombing that occurred in New Jersey. Come here, brother. You got a question?
Yeah, would you guys pray for me? Both my family are from the Issachar tribe. They're both from Mexico.
Wow, look at that. All patients. So you know what that makes you? An Israelite. Now, give me the scripture, Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4. I want you, brother and sister, to listen good to this too. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4. This is why we come out here, to remind our people of who they are. Are you ready?
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17 and verse 4. And thou, even thyself.
So the Bible says, this is Jeremiah. Put the cigarette away. We want you to focus. You understand?
Yes,
the Bible says, he took one more hit. The Bible says, the Bible says, and thou, even thyself, which is who? Jeremiah, listen.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue.
Discontinue means, listen, you won't remember who you are anymore. And this is also going into Jeremiah. Now listen good, because you may ask, why don't we remember who we are? We go by the terms Jamaican, Trinidadian, Puerto Rican, Guatemalan, Mexican. But guess what? These are all names that was given to us in slavery. It was a part of our destruction. Think about it. This is why blacks and Hispanics, there's that animosity, that hatred. We Puerto Ricans feel as though they better. Black people feel like they're better. Haitians don't like nobody. You understand? Read on.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thine heritage.
Your heritage, what's your name?
Renee.
Yeah. Your heritage, Renee, is you're an Israelite. We, as a people, discontinued from our language. You speak Spanish or no?
Of course.
Okay, all praises. So, guess what? Spanish is not your language.
No.
That's the language you learned. English was not our language. That's the language we learned. In Ghana, what do they speak? Tree. That was not their language. That's the language they learned. Come on.
Discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee.
Because that's what's heavy about it. The Most High gave us this. Hey, so stay here, brother from Ghana. Get a flyer, brother. The Most High gave us this race, this nationality, our name. You understand? Hold that. Get Numbers chapter 6 and verse 27, I believe. Renee, we want you to understand that God is dealing with blacks and Hispanics, but he's dealing with us when we keep the commandments. You understand?
Absolutely.
So listen to this. Is that 627 what I want? All right, go ahead. Yep.
The book of Numbers, chapter 6, and verse 27. And they shall put my name.
God told Moses to tell the Israelites, to instruct them that they shall put my name
upon the children of Israel.
Upon the children of Israel. So what does that mean? There's honor that comes with being called an Israelite. Back to Jeremiah 17. Oh yeah, read it again. Go ahead.
And they shall put my name.
My what?
My name.
There is no honor in calling yourself Boricua.
Right.
There is no honor in calling yourself Jamaican, There is no honor in calling yourself African American. The honor is your God's chosen people. The honor is Judah, Benjamin, Levi. What does Judah mean, you so-called Negroes? No. It means praise of the Most High. That's what the name Judah means. All right? And what does Issachar mean, your name? He is hired. I guarantee you, you'll get a job before me. Because them Mexicans work real hard. You understand?
And with the beast of
exactly. And listen, that's part of the prophecy. That is part of the prophecy. Finish what you were saying.
My name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them.
God says, and I will bless them. He will bless us. He will. But you know what we must do, Renee? We gotta repent. We have to repent. That's, you know what, that part of repentance is what? You gotta put away the drugs. You have to put away the drugs. If you're a drug dealer, you gotta put it away. Right. If you smoke weed, you gotta put it away. Right. If you're a whoremonger, you gotta stop.
Right.
If you're a homosexual, you must change.
Bring it out.
You can't go halfway with the Most High.
Bring it out.
Get Revelations chapter 2. Revelations chapter 2 and verse 25, I believe it is. The book of Revelations chapter 2 and verse 25.
But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come.
But that which ye have already, hold fast till I come. Brothers and sisters, what do we have? You sisters right over there, what do you have? You brothers right over here, what do you have? The Bible. The Bible. Hey, I heard some brothers call it basic instructions before leaving earth. That's the little acronym they put on it. And listen, you know what? I like that. Why? Because there is full of instructions in this Bible. This Bible is full of laws. This Bible is full of what? Ceremonies of what we ought to celebrate. This Bible is full of the best part, prophecy. Prophecy. You understand? And why do I say the best part? Because that's how we remember who we are. The prophecy. Come on now. Revelation 2:25, one more time.
That which ye have already, hold fast till I come.
Now go to chapter 3, verse 15.
Look at this.
Revelation chapter 3, verse 15. And I know thy works, and that thou art neither cold nor hot.
We're neither cold
nor hot.
Hot for this truth. Keeping the commandments. You're a serious-minded brother. Cold is talking about sin. Like brothers say, yo, that brother over there is cold-hearted. It's talking about sin. Listen to what God says.
I would thou,
work cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of thy mouth.
Of my mouth.
Why did I go here? Because we cannot be lukewarm. Lukewarm goes into what? You're only going to do some of God's laws. Guess who's lukewarm? The Christian church.
Right.
They are lukewarm. Read that part again.
So, I would...
Is it right here?
I would thou work cold or hot.
God says, I would rather you despise my word or you apply my word. Make a decision. Read on.
So then, because thou art lukewarm,
but because you're in the middle, lukewarm, come on,
and neither cold nor hot,
and you've neither made a decision to either despise my word or follow my word, thank you,
I will spew thee out of my mouth.
How does God spew you out of his mouth? He dismisses you. He kills you. He harms you. He puts afflictions on you. Now the black man is mad. The black man is angry. Renee, guess what? God is not just going to cause affliction to come upon the black man. It's also the Hispanic brothers. Guess what? Guess who's a forsaken tribe? The Native Americans. Who are the Native American Indians? The tribe of Gad. What does the tribe of Gad mean? Troop! What was the last tribe the so-called white man conquered? The Native American Indians. In fact, When he conquered them, he needed help. And they were called what? All of you brothers that listen to Bob Marley, Buffalo Soldiers. They were the Jamaicans, some of the Mexicans, and the American blacks. He used those three to help overthrow the so-called Native American Indians. But why does he do this? Psalms chapter 83 and verse 4. You could drop everything else. God, why does the so-called white man, why does he try his best to keep blacks and Hispanics divided? Divided. Read what he gave you. I want to see what it is. What did he give you? Let's see. Let's see if it was a flyer to a church.
Go and pray to me.
Hold on.
Go and pray to me. If I had cherished sin in my heart, the Lord would not have listened. But God has surely listened and has heard my prayer. Praise.
Oh, wait, stop. The brother, the Christian, the word of God is coming out. He walks over to the brother listening and just, here, take this. Why? Why do they do that? Because they know there's no truth in that. This is called poison. This is no different from selling drugs to your own people. This is poison. Christianity is worse than crack cocaine. You understand? This is a mental destruction. You understand? This is a... Also, what that is racism too. Because he said, you know what, there's a light-skinned brother. Don't listen to them blacks over there. They're crazy. They don't know what they're talking about. Because that's how a lot of Hispanics roll. Oh, he's black? Yeah, don't deal with them. You've been taught that before.
I dealt it with my dark-skinned Mexican people. I dealt it with...
Exactly. And look, now the brother gave you Matthew 6 and 6. He gave you some other scriptures. Go to Matthew 6. Finish where you at. Sorry, let's finish where you at. Let's put it... whatever you want to do with that. Matthew 6 and 6. I mean, wait. Yeah, Psalms 83 and 4.
The book of Psalms, chapter 83 and verse 4. They have said, come.
Who has said come? The UN. That's where all the nations come together. They have said. Where is the UN? In Manhattan. Once you cross the 59th Street Bridge, you see it. The UN building, and they have all the ambassadors and delegates of all nations. Please tell me, who is representing the Negro in the UN? Who goes to the UN and speaks on the behalf of brothers from Brownsville, Brooklyn? Speaks on the behalf of brothers from Jamaica, Queens? Speaks on the behalf of brothers from South Side of Chicago? Speaks on the behalf of brothers from Detroit and Flint? Nobody. Nobody. But they will supply drugs to the community. They will do that. They will grant money to organizations to build churches. They will do that. They will grant money to build new schools, charter schools, in South Ozone Park, Jamaica, Queens, Flushing. They will do that. Why? Because it's a part of the agenda. What's the agenda? To keep the Negroes down. Listen.
They have said, come and let us cut them off.
How do we cut off blacks and Hispanics? Education, religion, and politics.
Come, let us cut them off from being a nation.
Is the prophecy correct? Are blacks and Hispanics a nation? No. There's divisions between us. You understand? Blacks, think about it. When I went to college and I would go in, on one side you would see the Hispanic brothers, then you see the Jamaican brothers, you see the black brothers. There's a division. You understand? What's another proof? On these flag days, you see all of our people, they take pride in who they are. You understand? Read on.
Come, let us cut them off from being a nation. That the name.
That's what's so important. Because black brother, Hispanic brother, Native American Indian brother, if you remember what your real name was, then there's a problem. If you remembered what your real name was, there's a problem. Why? What comes with your real name? Your real character. You understand? Your real character. God named us Israel. Hold that. Isaiah chapter 45 and verse 4. Is it verse 4? Yes, four. Look at this. Oh, we already got you fast. The book of Isaiah, chapter 45 and verse 4. For Jacob, my servant's sake, and Israel, mine elect.
And Israel, mine elect. Come on.
I have even called thee by thy name.
I have even called you.
Where you from, brother? Where you from? What?
From Queens. Come closer. You're African-American or Jamaican Islands?
African-American.
I have even called thee by thy name. Watch this. Hey, look. When you were filling out your job application, you put black American, not Hispanic. We all do that. You will put Hispanic. But that's part of the division. You're not going to put Israelite because they don't acknowledge us to be the Jews. They despise that. You understand? Watch this.
I have surnamed thee.
God says, I have surnamed thee. Hey, brother, where you from, Puerto Rico? Puerto Rican brother. When it says, I have surnamed thee, you know what that means? On a marriage certificate, you'll see surname. And that usually means what? A surname. It's okay, it's not a Negro word. I didn't know it when I first read the Bible. I'm like, what is a surname? What does it mean, surname? Nope, nope, nope. What does it mean? Sister, you know what I mean? What does it mean? Exactly, your last name. No, it's okay. Hey, it's all right. Don't think, I'm slow. No, I didn't know what it meant when I first read the Bible. I did not know what surname meant. I had to get the dictionary. You understand? These are not Negro words. But what? The Most High is waking us up to where now we're reading. And so we can understand. So read it from the top.
For Jacob, my servant's sake.
We are Jacob. The Puerto Ricans are from the tribe of Ephraim, which means what? Fruitful. Puerto Ricans are very fruitful. How? Because I have yet this day to meet a single Hispanic household. It's always an extended family, children upon children upon children upon children. That was the blessing God gave Ephraim. That was the blessing God gave Ephraim. Come on.
And Israel, mine elect.
And Israel, us, we are Israel. Us, we are the Israelites. We are God's what?
Mine elect.
We are the chosen. That's what that means. That means that God, guess what? He pushed the nations out the way. The nations know this. That's why they meet at the UN to talk about which nation are we going to allow to study uranium. Which nation are we going to allow to practice their religion? Do you ever see the nations asking Puerto Rico their opinions on matters regarding the war? No. Say it again. Mexico? No. Who is in the UN? Russia. America. Syria. Israel. Africa. Sorry, not those African nations. Pakistan. Iran. These are nations that have a seat. And what are they talking about? How to keep America going. Some of them are mad. Of course, a lot of them are mad. They want to be in power. Nobody wants America in power. Why? Because America's a bully. Nobody wants America in power. But they will not dare speak against America in the UN. They know better. Come on.
I have even called thee by thy name.
Brother man, what's your name?
Ivan.
Now, the Bible says he has called us by our name. Watch what God says our name is.
I have surnamed thee.
Meaning I've gave you the last name.
Though thou hast not known me.
God gave us the last name Israel. 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 And guess what? Give me Numbers chapter 1 and verse 18.
Look at this.
We're going to get Numbers 1. And then we're going to get Deuteronomy 16:13. Yes, sir. I'm in the Old Testament, and then we're going to go to the New Testament. So I'm going to show you something. Back in our days, when we were in power, under King Solomon and King David, both are black men. We had what? We had order. We had an army. We had what? A government. We had a system. We had a chronological order of what? Family structures, family members. We had tribes. All of this governs a nation. What do we have to judge matters? The Bible. For example, in these other countries
America, they have a judicial system. Stay with me. America has a judicial system, right? If you go against certain laws, you're brought to court. You pass a red light. You're not driving with a seatbelt. You understand? If you're in another country, Syria, Iran, some of these countries are governed by Sharia law, which is Islam. You understand? Which is a book. You understand? My point is this. Our people, when we judge matters, we went back to a source. This Bible. That's why this Bible remains to be the number one selling book. So this was part of our nationality. All right, here we go. Numbers 1 and 18.
The book of Numbers, chapter 1 and verse 18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month.
Right, the congregation, guess what? Ivan and what's your name you mentioned? Brother with the post office, what's your name again?
Justin.
This is all the congregation right here. Ivan, this is where you're from, right here. The tribe of Ephraim, right there. All the congregation is the 12 tribes. Now look at this. Look at how we judged, how we divided our people. Deuteronomy. That's all I want, Deuteronomy 16.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 16, verse 18. Judges and officers shall thou make thee in thy gates.
Do you understand what that means, Justin? Justin, what's your name again?
Renee.
Read it again one more time. This is what the men held as a position. Listen.
Judges and officers.
The Bible called us judges and officers. You understand? Judges and officers, meaning what? We had a position to govern and to judge our people. You understand? Ivan, you with me? So watch this. Now, that's all I wanted. Let's go to the New Testament now. Let's get Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. Let me ask you a question. Ivan, who's our savior now? Who is the black and Hispanic man's savior? Exactly. What does he mean when he say that?
Yes,
exactly.
Yes,
not many people know him by that name. Look at this now. Go to Matthew 1:21. Look at this.
The book of Matthew, chapter 1, verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins.
So Yeshua, as he said, or Jesus the Christ, shall save his people. Who are his people? We are the 12 tribes, blacks and Hispanics. We are his selected group of people. Now, Ivan, second question. What color does he look like?
Brown.
What color does he look? Do you agree with what Ivan said?
Bronze,
okay. Okay. What color? Jesus. What color does he look like? Yeah. Every color. Okay, so we have brown, we have bronze, we have every color. Brother man, what color does Jesus look like? Okay, now I'm going to turn the sign over. I think it's this one. Hold on, watch out. This is it. Now, if Jesus Christ looked black, I don't know about you, but when I went to the Catholic Church as a young man, who's this? Who's that?
That's a figment of their imagination.
Okay, who's that, Renee? Who's this guy?
That's every name, that everyone. Every picture.
That's deception.
Yeah. Okay, deception.
Idol worship.
Okay, brother man, who's this? Nobody. Okay, hey, but not too many brothers have the knowledge you have. But when we grew up, who did we learn this was? Exactly, that's my point. Now watch this, Revelation chapter 1, verse 14.
The book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
Brother, Renee, point to somebody in the crowd that has woolly hair.
We do, bro. We do.
Exactly. There we go. There we go. Read it again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
I'm sorry. I don't know about y'all. I just like the way that sounds. Read it again.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
All nations do not have woolly hair. You understand? When I look at the Caucasian race, I will not look at them and describe them as a woolly head type of people. You understand? Everybody with me? Ivan, you with me?
Yeah, yeah.
Right, come on.
As white as snow.
Fully white is describing Christ, come on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Now, we grew up seeing this image, Ivan. Do any of these depictions, look, he has blue eyes. He has brown eyes. The Bible says the whites of his eyes were as a flame of fire. Why? Because Christ drank wine. Come on.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire and his feet.
Now, if Jesus Christ was all colors, let's see how John the Revelator described him. Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
What color is fine brass, brother man?
Come on, man.
He said, come on, man. Come on. Exactly. You understand? What color is fine brass, Ivan? Exactly. Brown. But listen, that doesn't mean Christ was high yellow. That means Christ was this dark. This dark. What does that mean? That there's honor in being a dark-skinned man. You understand? There's honor.
Now wait.
Before you go, one more thing. We got to keep the commandments according to the Bible.
Okay.
We're an Israelite according to the Bible. We gotta follow all of God's laws. You understand? The beer, the Ten Commandments, not being adulterer.
I'm letting it work, bro.
Oh, we can't have a bald head? These are part of the laws. Come on.
See that, right? See what they're training us to do?
What? And his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burn in a furnace.
As if they burned in a furnace. Now look, why do we see this type of image? Why? We can't just know the
answer. We have to know
why. Why did they do this? Think about it. If Jesus Christ is all colors, that would not say that. Because brass burned in the furnace is not all colors.
Right.
When you go in the furnace, you are coming out charcoal.
Right.
You are coming out dark,
right.
Black, cooked, burnt. You understand? So guess what? He's not all colors. He's not. The man has a color. The most famous man is a black man. So why do you think America is gunning us down? Because we're a threat to society. So wait, Psalms 55 and verse 20. What? Yes, sir. And also, what does that prove to the Hispanic brothers over here? Jesucristo es negro for you Hispanic brothers. Just make sure you understand. He's not a white man. He's no white. No blanco. Jesucristo es negro.
Right.
What do you want to say?
God are living on each individual. Remember that. We are the temple of God. He's no color. Around that. Bible doesn't talk about the color. Listen. We are the generation.
Psalms 55 verse 20. Now, brother man, you know what? You know what's going on? Christianity is going on in your brain right now. That's what it is. But you have to admit it. You gotta say, you know what, I'm struggling right now. This is the problem why they painted this. This is the answer. David gave it to us. Psalms 55 and 20.
The book of Psalms, chapter 55 and verse 20. He has put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
The Bible says he had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. Who in treating America with peace? Historically, the natives. The natives entreated the British, the French, the Dutch, the Portuguese with peace.
He had broken his covenant.
Because what did they make with the so-called Native American Indians? Covenants, agreements, treaties. Come on.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
This is how the white man speaks. He speaks smooth.
Well, listen, sir, the reason why we're here for your company is because we want you to understand. We want you to really get the reason why.
But he doesn't tell you what's in the fine print. Because once you sign a document, wait, why are you taking my house, my family, my name?
You didn't read the fine print.
This is how the man gets down. Guess what? The so-called white man is a true gangster. Because look at how he took this country. And he built courts, churches,
so
judges matters. And who fills the prisons? The sons of God. We do. The righteous are in jail and the wicked are judging matters.
That doesn't make sense. It's Bible prophecy. Come on.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
Why does he say the words of his mouth were smoother than butter? Because he came with the Bible and a gun. He used the Bible to manipulate the people. You understand? Oh, say it again, officer.
And also what I wanted to say, the Democrats, that's exactly what it is. See what the brother, that's how they killed us.
He used the cross. The cross is an evil symbol.
That's right. Also, the way the Democratic Party speaks to people. You think they're for you. You think they're for you, but they're not for you. The Democratic Party speaks nice. We're going to help minorities. We're going to build stores. Okay. They build, what the brother say? If you see a Starbucks in a bike lane in your neighborhood, that means you're out. Gentrification is coming. The Democratic Party, I'm going to say this real quick, has been against our people for a long time, for a very long time. They said we love minorities, with this, that, and the other. Hillary Clinton, Obama, words like butter, but it's evil because they're doing the gangster stuff behind the scene. That's what the brother said. They're the real gangsters. They bomb countries. You understand?
So you understand this cross, like the brother just mentioned, an officer, this cross, they brought the cross with them and they burned you at a stake if you didn't bow down to a cross. The cross is an evil image. If you have a cross in your house, you need to get rid of it.
Idol
it's idol worship. This is how you know who the satanic followers are. The crucifix, the crescent moon, these are all idols. Listen, finish reading.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart.
What was in the white man's heart?
But war was in his heart.
What did he do? Remember, there was a famous president that we learned about in school. His name was Andrew Jackson. He came with what? The U.S. Cavalry. And what else did they have? It was called a Gatling gun. How did they kill the Native Americans? Once you start moving it around, what happens? Bodies all over the place. What was in his heart?
But war was in his heart.
What book are we reading? The Holy Bible.
That's right.
This is telling us what was going to happen. This is the book of prophecy. Come on.
His words were softer than oil. Yet,
this is our history. So now, why are we viewed as a threat? Psalms chapter 50 and verse 20. This is why we are furthermore a threat, because we are the princes of the power. We are the princes of the Most High. You understand? That's why they must spend billions of dollars to keep us down. Because guess what? If Haitians, Puerto Ricans, Jamaicans, Negroes, Mexicans, if we unite in the keeping of God's laws, this government will fall down.
That's right.
It's gonna fall. Why? Because these are righteous men that are disciplined, that are moving in one spirit. Read
the book of Psalms, chapter 50, and verse 20. Thou sittest and speakest against thy brother.
Who spoke against thy brother? Esau. Hold that. Genesis 25:25. Who's Esau? Who is Esau? Exactly. Who spoke against their brother, Esau? We're going to find out who Esau is.
The book of Genesis, chapter 25, and verse 25. And the first came out red.
What color did the first come out?
Red.
Came out red.
What color did the first child come out?
Red.
What race has red, is red, looks red, and we call them rednecks? It's the so-called white man. The Bible describes him as red. But they said, no, we're going to call ourselves white, which means pure, which means righteous. Guess what? Without evil intent. That's what this word means. But God says, no. I'm going to call them red because that's their color. Go on, read it again.
And the first came out red.
God calls the white man red. Read.
All over like a hairy garment.
And what did God call his name?
And they called his name Esau.
So the so-called white man, his biblical name is Esau, the red man.
Edom. Edom. That's his name. Now back to Psalms. Wait, read the rest of the part. Watch this.
26. And after that came his brother out, and his hand took hold of Esau's heel.
Now, how come it doesn't describe what Jacob looked like? This is the birth of Esau and Jacob. How come it didn't describe what Jacob looked like? Because Jacob was black just like you, was black just like everybody else. Black people being born of dark pigment wasn't a shock. That was normal. But what wasn't normal was somebody being born without pigment, which today we call albinos. You understand? This is the birth of Esau. So watch this. Go back to Psalms 55. Watch this.
The book of Psalms, chapter 50, verse 20. Thou sittest and speaketh against thy brother.
So who is our brother? The so-called white man. Why? Because we have the same father and mother. So yes, we do come from the same parents. But God said he would separate us. Come on.
Thou slanderest thine own mother's son.
And guess what? How is he slandering us? Because he says we are not the Jews. The so-called Jews live in Israel. That's not true. That's slander. Come on.
Verse 21. These things hast thou done, and I kept silent.
Why? Where did it start? Where did it start? Slavery. Because guess what? When our wives were being raped, when our men were being raped, when our babies were being crushed, when our sisters were being destroyed, heads chopped off. This is the big question.
I gotta go, thank you.
This is the big question. Where was God during slavery? That's why God says, these things has thou done, but I kept silence. God says, I'm gonna step back and I'm gonna let this man do his wickedness. That's what happened. Because why didn't God?
How far he go with it.
Exactly. Why did God allow the white man to do such cruel things?
Jenga.
I was watching a documentary. And in the documentary, it was about slavery. And in slavery, I didn't know this, but listen. In slavery, gynecology, is that what it's called?
Yes.
Gynecology, it's not a Negro word. Gynecology, the father of gynecology, the person who's practiced this, their forefather, James Marion Sims, I believe his name is, practiced on black women in slavery without anesthetics, without anesthesia. So guess what? He said these women were born to feel pain. They could go through this. So guess what? In slavery, the so-called white man, he had experiments on the black woman to learn about their vagina. This is slavery. This is history that we don't learn in school. The white man studied the vagina of a black woman, and that's how he learned how to study and cure diseases. We were the experiments. And we have to bring this history out. I know it's too hard to digest, but you must remember it. You have to. We have to. Read it again.
These things has thou done, and I kept silent.
One of the things that he did, he studied slaves, opened our skulls to study brains. Because guess what? The science. He gives the glory and credit to science. But no, it was us. It was us. God says these things what?
These things has thou done, and I kept silent.
Right. He slandered us. He murdered us. Now, go back to Genesis 25 and verse 23. Because you may think about it. Terrence Crutcher, Tulsa, Oklahoma, was shot down days ago. The officer, Betty Shelby, approached the vehicle with another officer. One officer took out a stun gun and shot it. Betty Shelby said, I was in fear for my life, so I shot him and killed him. The way we know it happened was the helicopter footage. Did you guys see the video? Right, watch the video. His name is Terrence Crutcher. Charlotte, North Carolina. His name is Keith Scott. officers did not want to release the video. That's why Charlotte was in mayhem and they called them the National Guard. Why? Because they said these niggas are crazy. They are off the chain. Because you know how our people get. We can easily destroy something, but it's very hard for us to come together and build something. You understand? That's why God put the Israelites and boots on the ground. Because that's our job, to build. Drug dealers gotta repent. Whoremongers gotta repent. Why? Because God is calling everybody in all their wicked lives.
What's a whoremonger?
A whoremonger, right? Exactly. To repent, to change. A whoremonger is a man that sleeps with multiple women. Guess what? A whoremonger can also be a sister. God is calling every... Listen, all of us was wicked up here. We had to repent. You understand? Gang members, drug dealers, lawyers, whatever it was. All of us.
Repent means that. Stop.
You gotta change. Exactly. Exactly. Oh, some of us up here were drug users. You understand? But when we heard repentance, we took it. Now, why did I mention about those two black men being shot? Because remember the guy from Staten Island with his hands up? Eric Garner. Then it was Trayvon Martin. Then it was Ramali Grant. And then there was Hispanic brothers. And I'm sorry, I don't remember their names, but they didn't get any media coverage. A lot of black men are being shot down. Why? What's going on? Here's the Bible, the biblical answer. Genesis 25, verse 21.
The book of Genesis, chapter 25 and verse 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren.
So Isaac was married to Rebecca. Rebecca was barren. Barren means the woman cannot give forth a child. Come on.
And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebecca, his wife, conceived.
So Rebecca eventually became pregnant. Watch this. We're building a case. We're going to our biblical history to understand modern problems. Once again, we're going to our biblical history to understand modern problems. Come on.
And the children struggled together within her.
So Rebecca says, God, if you have blessed me with a child, why are the babies struggling in my womb? Why do I feel fighting in my womb? I shouldn't feel this. This is not normal. Come on.
And she said, if it be so, why am I thus?
So Lord, if this is your will for me to have children, why is this happening?
And she went to inquire of the Lord.
What does it mean she went to inquire of the Lord? Sister Rebecca, a black woman, prayed to the Most High God.
And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
And we read about those two nations earlier. Esau and Jacob are the two nations. God has heard her prayer and said, listen, two nations are in your womb. This is the birth of our 12 tribes and of the so-called white man. It says two nations, come on.
And two manner of people.
And two what?
Two manner of people.
And two what?
And two manner of people.
Meaning these two people, these two babies in your womb are different. One is going to be of one manner, the other is going to be of another manner, two manner. But wait, how can you have two different babies in the same womb? What type of twins do we call those today? Fraternal twins. You understand? Watch this. Two twins that don't look alike. You understand? Because you have identical twins, then you have fraternal twins. Come on.
And two manner of people shall be separated.
That's the proof that they were fraternal twins. They were separated. One was red, the other was brown. Come on.
Shall be separated from thy bowels.
So God is not a God of unity of all races. Right here is proof that God says, listen, I'm going to separate one. One is going to be of one manner, another is going to be of another manner. We read Psalms 55 later on. War was in his heart. This is the white man's nature. He is a violent man. This is why what just recently happened in New York. Ahmad Rahami. Where was he? An Afghan? I think he was Afghanistan. I'm not sure. What did he do? He took a bomb that he made himself, placed it in a garbage can, walked away, boom! Had everybody scared. Running.
Then what happened? Went to New Jersey. There was another bomb. Now they found it, but it exploded. Nobody got hurt. Why are these occurring in America? Yes. It was so bad. I don't know if you guys remember. You got a text message on your phone. Who remembers that? I had a text message on my phone that said, alert, look for that man. Who knows what I'm talking about? You didn't get that text?
Everybody got
y'all got that text.
Even on that's Obama phone.
Yeah, it was on what?
On Obama phone.
Yeah. Right. It was on my phone too. It was like 8 o'clock in the morning. It was like a very early in the morning. Yep. It was crazy. It was like, that means, you know what that means? If they can send a mass text of things like that, they can do a lot of damage to us. But that's why we're not fighting the government, if they can control your phone. But that they had a mass text for that man. So when America gets hurt, they don't play. But when we get hurt, oh, forget about it. Like the white lady told us last night, get over slavery, get over it. And this is the thing. Now, this is the point we're going to bring up. Ahmad Rahami had a bomb. It went off. 29 injured. Brothers, is he alive? Is he alive, Ivan? Is he alive? Exactly. He's alive in critical condition. Terrence Crutcher, a black man, probably don't know how, most likely don't know how to make a bomb. Is he alive? No. So how on one end you get a terrorist, shoots at the police, right? Shoots at the police. Police fires back, makes sure they don't kill him. But Terrence Crutcher, a black man, makes sure that nigga goes down. Two manner of people. When the so-called white man sees us, what do they see? Niggas. They see violence. They see the wicked. This is how he thinks. You understand? The Bible says two manner of people. And what are our people doing? Protesting. Hosea 5:15. Yes, sir.
Also, real quick, you have your athletes like Stephen Curry. You got your Shannon Sharps. They're always talking in the news about what we got to do. You saw when LeBron James and Chris Paul. Y'all saw that, right? When LeBron, Chris Paul, Dwayne Wade, they was on the ESPY Awards, and they said we're going to do things to fix the issues with the police. Brothers, let me tell you straight, it's not going to fix. There's nothing, that's not going to change that. They had, who was it, LeBron James, it was Chris Paul, Dwayne Wade, Carmelo Anthony, there was another brother, Dwayne Wade, it was somebody else. It was Shannon Sharp on the show Undisputed, Stephen A. Smith. They always speak about Colin Kaepernick. You have all those guys trying to fix it, but they can't fix it that way because we've been trying that way for decades and it's not working. The way that we're going to fix it is we have to unite in the Bible. That's the only way we're going to fix it. Because if we all unite in the Bible, because that has never been done before. There was no revolution that was done by uniting in the Bible. We tried the Panther way with the guns in the street. The Panthers, what they tried. The Black Panthers tried their best. They tried it. But what happened, they ended up getting shot up by the police. They ended up fleeing to Cuba. Some of them fled to different countries. The Panthers tried it, it didn't work. Martin Luther King, as peaceful as he was, did not work. You understand? As peaceful as he was, they shot him. You understand? Malcolm X, same thing. He gets FBI was tapping his phone, and it didn't work. Young Lords, with the Brown Berets, the Chicano movement with the Mexicans. We always had done things to try to unite and get justice from the system. But we're not going to get justice from a system that was against us during the time of slavery. The laws that they create are not even for us. You understand?
A natural law. Right. So I'm asking you a question. This is like the newer testament.
Right. Get a flyer, brother. Get a flyer. Come get a flyer, man, all right? Yeah. We got a flyer. You in high school?
Right, yeah.
So learn this. Stay here and learn this, all right? Listen to this now. Hosea 5:15. We're going over the five biblical answers for modern problems. Why we're being shot down in the street. No. We got to repent. We're the Israelites. Stay and learn this, but listen to this. Come on. The book of Hosea, chapter 5, verse 15. I will go and return to my place. I will go and return to my place, God says. Where did he return? To the heavens. Come on.
Till they acknowledge their offense.
This is what it is. God says, until my people acknowledge their offense. Read.
and seek my face in their affliction.
They will seek me early. This is why young black men are being shot down. This is why our people are being oppressed. This is why we're seeking justice, but we're not getting justice. Why? Because this government is against our people. This government is against our people. What does God want us to do? Repent as an Israelite. That's our nationality. You understand? This is our nationality. Get John 3 and 3. We're about to close out. John chapter 3, verse 3. God says, until they acknowledge their offense. What's our offense? That we're evil. That we've committed sins worthy of death. That we've despised the Most High. That we've pushed truth to the side. We must acknowledge the sins of what we did. You understand? We've tried everything. Nothing has worked. We've yet to try the truth of the Bible. Because the Christian church is not the answer. The Christian church is not the answer. The Christian church is a business. It's a virus. Our black sisters and Hispanic sisters must get themselves in order and follow the righteous black man. The Israelite man. The disciplined man. Read this. The book of John, chapter 3, verse 3.
Jesus answered and said unto him,
who's the him? Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews.
Verily, verily, I say unto thee,
who's speaking? Jesus the Christ, a black man with white woolly hair.
Except a man be born again.
Black man, Hispanic man, black woman, Hispanic woman, all of us must be born again. What does that mean? Change your mind.
Right.
Change your mind. Read.
Except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.
What does that mean? Christ is only coming for those who repent. 2 Esdras 9 and 7. We're about to close out. 2 Esdras 9 and 7. Christ, listen, brothers and sisters, pay very close attention to this. According to the Bible, God has nuclear bombs coming to this country.
Right.
God has missile technology coming to this place.
Right.
That's why America is trying to what? Hold back on the war.
Right.
They want to rule wickedly, but one thing they don't want, they don't want these other countries to start pushing those buttons. Why do you think everybody's afraid of Donald Trump becoming president? Because they're afraid of him hitting the button. What does that mean? America is no longer in existence. But there's another plan. God has a plan. God has a plan. Hold that. 1 Corinthians 15:24. What's God's plan? We're going to show you how this country's going to be taken down. Because a lot of our people are singing the Lord's Prayer. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. You know what that means? America's going to be pushed out the way. Iran pushed out the way. China out the way. Japan out the way. Read this.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 24. Then cometh the end.
Then cometh the end.
When he shall have...
When he, read that again.
When he,
who, the black Messiah, Jesus Christ.
Then cometh the end when he shall deliver up the kingdom of God.
How is he going to deliver up the kingdom of God? Because the Israelites, we will be building the kingdom. How? We're doing it now. We're doing it now. We're trying to raise up 144,000.
Right.
Once that number's sealed, it's over.
When he shall deliver up the kingdom of God, even the Father, when he shall put down all rule,
God, Christ, the Messiah, when he shall put down
all rule,
all empire,
and all authority, and
all countries,
and power,
and power. This is the Lord's Prayer. You're asking for America to be no more. That's what you're asking. So think about what you're praying for. Because if you don't want America no more, we gotta change now. Come on.
For he must reign.
For he must reign. What does that mean? Rule. Christ has to rule because he's Lords of Lords and King of Kings. 2 Esdras 9 and 7, and then that's it. We're going to close out. This is what we have to do.
The book of 2 Esdras, chapter 9 and verse 7. And everyone that shall be saved.
Everyone that shall be saved. That's you. That's you. Because we've repented. We've changed. We put away adultery. We put away weed. We put away drugs. We become righteous men. Everyone that shall be saved.
And shall be able to escape his works.
And shall be able to escape. Escape what? Nuclear fire to this country. We will escape if we keep the laws. Come on.
And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works.
By his what?
By his works.
That means you put a beard. That means you kept the Sabbath day. Today's God's Sabbath day. That means you believe you're an Israelite. That means you wore fringes. That means you treated your wife with respect. That means what? Your wife honored you, respected you. Brothers and sisters, we have a lot of changing to do. Come on.
By his works and by faith.
And by faith. Why does it say by faith? Because is God coming down talking to us? Is God, the black God with woolly hair, talking to us? No. He's talking to us through the Bible. That's how he's talking to us. That's why the scripture says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. You understand? This is a faith walk. You understand? Come on.
Whereby ye have believed.
Whereby? By faith in our works we have believed.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.